Paul Conway works hard to stay in shape. He takes brisk walks around his Chula Vista neighborhood with his wife, Grace. And he pumps iron at least 3 times a week. Okay, so he doesn't look like Arnold Schwarzenegger. But back in his prime, Conway was a competitive bodybuilder.
Right now, I know I'll never look like I did when I was 22 years old, when I won the Board of State. That's a long time ago. I'm glad I did it. I'm glad I won it. But now all I can do is be the best 53-year-old I can be.
You wouldn't know it by looking at him, but Conway has end-stage heart disease. So what's keeping him alive? A heart pump called a left ventricular assist device, or LVAD for short. The device is implanted in Conway's chest. It's powered by special batteries that Conway keeps in a fanny pack. When Conway goes to sleep at night, he plugs the device into the wall. Conway says after he first complained of shortness of breath in 2005, doctors discovered he had a blocked artery, so they put in a stent. His heart problems continued, and Conway had to have more stents put in.
But in 2008, one of those 10 stents had two blood clots go into it. They blocked the major artery, I believe. I forget the technical name, but they call it the Widowmaker, I think it is. And it had a heart attack, my body, and it destroyed probably over 50% of my heart.
After that, Conway grew weaker and weaker.
He couldn't even walk up the stairs. He couldn't leave the house. He couldn't go out and get our mail. He was short of breath all the time, and we couldn't do hardly anything. And it was scary. It was very scary. And the kids had asked me at one point, are we still going to have a dad? And that was a hard thing to answer.
Conway was put on the waiting list for a heart transplant in 2010. As a stopgap measure, surgeons put in an LVAD.
It wasn't that long ago that people who had a severely diseased heart either had to get a transplant or they die. But these days, people can live for years with a heart pump.
This tube goes inside the heart, and then this tube goes into the aorta, the big blood vessel coming out of the heart on the other side, and it pumps blood through it.
Sharp cardiac surgeon Walter Dembitsky has put LVADs into dozens of patients with end-stage heart disease. He's trained surgeons all over the world in the use of the pumps. The devices were originally designed to serve as a bridge to transplant, but Dembitsky has had patients who've lived for years with an LVAD, including one man who's had the pump for more than a decade.
It is a proven fact that this is good for you if you have terminal heart failure. It's good for your survival. It's good for your quality of life. It's good technology.
But LVADs aren't perfect. They increase the risk of stroke, and they're not appropriate for every patient with advanced heart disease. Still, they've become a viable option since donated hearts are in such short supply. The nonprofit group Lifesharing oversees organ donations in San Diego and Imperial counties. Executive Director Lisa Stocks says it takes a very special set of circumstances for someone to become a heart donor.
The person has to die in a hospital with a brain injury while their heart is still beating. They have to be of a certain age where the heart is still viable. And their family has to consent for donation, or they have to be on the registry to donate.
Nationwide each year, there are only around 2,100 donated hearts. Currently, there are 30 San Diegans waiting for one, including Paul Conway. He's been on the list for more than 2 years. He has to stay within 2 hours driving distance of Sharp Hospital at all times in case a heart becomes available. In the meantime, Conway's learned to live with his LVAD, and so have his daughters.
It's kind of sad, but it's mostly fun because he can still do most things. Like, he still takes us places, like, and he still goes to Disneyland with us, and he can go on the roller coasters, some of them still.
I guess it's just cool because he's, like, all robot.
Conway says he's hanging tough until he gets his heart transplant.
I mean, I know it's here, and I know it can be aggravating, but every time I look at it, if I do get aggravated at it, I say it saved my life. It gave me three more Christmases, three more New Year's, three more Halloweens with my daughters and my wife, so how can you complain about that?
Kenny Goldberg, KPBS News.